I think it's important to say quite a lot of people have nightmares. About 2 to 5% of the general population has nightmares. Nightmares are extremely emotional dreams, negative emotions, obviously. And in a nightmare, you know what the storyline is, so you know what's happening. And also, if you awake from a nightmare, you know quite quickly that you had nightmares, so you know it was a dream. Nightmares are definitely linked to other disorders. In general, people who have nightmares are more prone to have depression, anxiety, other psychopathology, but also personality disorders. Actually, we did a study in specialistic mental health care, and we saw that about 30% of the people had nightmares. And it was not limited to post-traumatic stress disorder, but also depression, anxiety, etc. So basically, people who have nightmares are more prone to have other problems and the other way around. So we actually don't really know what purpose nightmares have. So in people with post-traumatic stress disorder, obviously it may not have a purpose, but people have it because they had a traumatic experience. But why people keep having nightmares, we actually don't really know. Because they have them more often, they kind of come back. And so sometimes they just have the nightmares because they are kind of trained to have the nightmares. So actually, the most people who have lots of nightmares, so those 2 to 5% of people that have one or more nightmares a week, most often they have reoccurring nightmares, and it is that they have nightmares that come back. So it can be a general theme, like being chased or falling or drowning or things like that, or something they actually experienced, like a trauma, like a car crash. And I think it's good to take it a bit more broadly to dreams, and dreams can say something. Sometimes you, because you have some sort of an unfiltered brain, you can get ideas from dreams. At the same time, the kind of general things that you hear from dream interpretation, they're normally, I would say, not based on science. I would say it's more likely that people saw a cobra on the television, and that's why they're dreaming about a cobra, and it's not about transformation or whatever. So the thing is, in a dream, you're not able to think about what you're dreaming and why you're dreaming it. And that's why it's quite unfiltered. Because it's unfiltered, you can get all these crazy ideas that can be interesting, but also can be just rubbish. So if you think about it the next day and it is an interesting idea, then it could be. But on the other hand, most often it's also not. So, and I think that's the same with nightmares. On the other hand, you have nightmares, obviously, that you dream about things that you experienced or where you are dealing with during the day, and obviously it says something. But then again, it needs to say something during the day as well. So you have to think about that we have about 200,000 dreams in a lifetime, which is a lot. And based on chance, probably people will have the same dreams, especially if they talk to each other up front and they talk to each other about what kind of dreams they will have or want to have, then they might end up having the same dream. So people may have the same dream, but it's probably because they talked about it. And since we know that what you think about or what you are occupied with comes back into your dream, kind of makes sense that they may have the same dream. But this is something different than they're actually into each other's dream, because that would be telepathy and then would be fascinating, but I think it's still not proven. As I said, the most people that have lots of nightmares have recurrent nightmares, and the treatment that is most effective and also well studied is imagery rehearsal therapy. What you actually do is during the day, you write down your nightmare. So for instance, it's about being chased by a monster, so you write it down into detail, and then you start thinking on the ending and how you would like it to be ending. So, well, it's a dream, anything can happen, so whatever you want is okay. So would you like to chase the monster yourself, change into Superman, move it around, or actually become friends with the monster? Anything goes, as long as you're happy with it. And then what you do is you kind of imagine that during the day, because you imagine that in the you first let emotions go up and then go down, because you kind of get away from them. And this transition is probably the thing why nightmares don't come back anymore at night, because the emotions are ameliorated and they improve, and people kind of don't have the nightmare then anymore at night.